starring Gladys Knight and the Pips, The Honeycomb, Bobby Hutton, and special guest star Eddie Kendricks and the Soul Train Gang. Here's your host, Don Cornelius.
Hi there and welcome aboard. You're right on time for a beautiful trip on the Soul Train. And if the sight and sound of soul is your pleasure and what you treasure, you can bet your bottom we got them, baby. And after message from the Johnson Products Company, three of the most beautiful and talented sisters you've ever seen in your life are going to be looking you dead in your eyes where your beauty lies. Out now for the fabulous Honeycomb showing up, rocking them back, and that ain't no fiction, baby. It's a natural fact.
A young man, single and free, experience and love and bad, but we'll accept the young trainee. Oh, we're gonna put it in the whole ass. I need a love that's true. I'm gonna put it in the whole ass. My man.
The Honeycomb will be back later in the show with another burner, and right now we'd like you to meet two members of our Soul Train gang.
My name's Jan Robinson.
Hey, Jan.
And my name is Rodney Miles.
Hello, Rodney. Jan and Rodney, I can remember when there were only a few standard type dances, but now you know the scene has changed, and there are many, many dances. And I'm wondering, did either of you ever stop to think of how many dances you've learned since you first started dancing?
Well, there's really many.
Why don't you rattle off as many as you can?
The Breakdown, Mechanical Man,
Crack Eject, Exercise.
The Philly Dog and the Jerk.
Dirty.
You know how to do all these dances.
Oh, yeah.
Okay,
it's really, really fantastic. Now, this next jam is by a man who's probably made more people dance than anyone else in the history of soul music. That's why we call him the first name in the soul game. James Brown, the mighty JB's, and a boss piece, y'all, what they chose to call Make It Funky.
I got the Make it fun.
Okay, James Brown getting that stuff tough enough on the Soul Train, and I have here in my hand a most exciting album entitled All By Myself. It was recorded by a man who gained a great deal of fame during his career as a lead singer in one of the world's most popular groups, The Temptations. May we have a Soul Train welcome for the one, the only, Eddie Kendricks.
I did it all for you.
Johnny, that was too beautiful for words. As a matter of fact, the album is one of the most beautiful things I've ever heard, and I'd like to congratulate you on it. And I was just wondering how you came by a tune that was so appropriate for the Eddie Kendrick style.
Well, I have to thank Mr. Frank Wilson, the producer of the album. He won and selected all the tunes.
Mm-hmm. Very wonderful. Now, Eddie, let me ask you one other question. How does it feel now that you're traveling alone after traveling so many years with the Temps?
Well, it's kind of lonesome. You don't have many fellas out there with you, you know, to talk to.
I can dig it.
That's the only difference I can see.
Okay, Eddie Kendricks will be back later in the show, and Eddie, we certainly wish for you the continued success that you deserve. Soul Train Gang, let's give it up one more time for Eddie.
The Soul Train!
And now let's all get some hands together for four beautiful people who represent a mighty mountain of soul, the very gifted and talented Gladys Knight and the dancing, swinging, singing Pips. On this next one now, we'll give two members of the Soul Train Gang what you might call an unusual view of themselves. It's the mighty wicked Mr. Wilson Pickett laying his soul on the line, saying his thing so beautiful and so fine. Pickett said, just call my name, little mama, I'll be there.
The sun is shining high up above.
Wilson Pickett and the Biggin, everybody's kind of Biggin. What's your name?
Dwayne Durden.
Dwayne?
Natalia Combs.
Hi, Natalia. Dwayne, I'm sure you and Natalia have a pretty good idea what you look like when you're dancing, right?
Yeah.
Okay, we have you on the Soul Train replay machine, and we're going to ask you to identify the dance and tell us if you agree with what the machine says. Take a look at the monitor right over here. Dwayne, what do you call that dance?
One they call the dirt. And...
You always do it that slow?
No. Usually a little fast.
I don't say. Okay, we thank you, Dwayne, and we thank you, Natalia, and you can believe the Soul Train replay machine will strike somebody else the next time. As often as possible, we'll present relatively new recording artists who we feel show a great deal of promise. Our next guest is from Chicago, Illinois, and he's as handsome as he is talented. We think his latest recording on the Phillips Mercury label entitled You're My Whole Reason just might be the big one he's been waiting for. May we have a warm welcome for the exciting Mr. Bobby Hutton.
You're my whole reason, rising for the morning sun. You're my only reason, rising for the morning sun. You're my umbrella in a rainstorm. You're my sunshine when the rain.
Okay, we're back with Gladys and the Pips, seated in what we call Soul Train Hot Seats. And Gladys, for the benefit of those in our audience who are not familiar with the group, we're going to ask you all to introduce yourselves and tell us where you're from.
My name is Gladys Knight.
My name is Gladys Knight.
My name is Gladys Knight.
Okay, give me the real Gladys Knight, all right?
All right.
Seriously,
man. Come on.
I miss
that guy. Seriously, my name is William Guest.
My name is Merrill Knight. Bubba.
Merrill.
No, man. Bubba. Just Bubba. Okay,
my name is Edward Patton.
Yeah, to think about that.
And my name is Gladys Knight.
The
can call these seats hot seats because instead of me interviewing you, you'll be interviewed by the Soul Train gang, and needless to say, they're not likely to ask the same questions that I would ask. Are you ready? Yeah. Okay, first question.
Get it out.
Right here.
My name is Cheryl Ratliff, and I'd like to ask Gladys, how do you like being the only girl?
It's a gas most of the time, but these fellas can be a headache, you know. But I think I like it better than working with girls.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
My name is Rochelle Ridley, and Gladys, how long have you and the Pips been together?
18 years.
Okay, my name is Karen Knox, and I noticed that a lot of the groups today, they usually sing songs that relate to our world of today, and I'd like to know that most of the songs that you sing, most of the time do you sing them, are you trying to relate some type of message to the outside world?
Well, yes, when we do message songs, I think everything that we do has a message, but I imagine that you're speaking of political things or something like that, right? Say like the Friendship Train. That was the kind of message song you were talking about, right? But as far as projecting a certain thing, every song that I sing, I try to relate to it. If I can't relate to it in some manner, then it's no good for me because I try to put myself in every song that we do.
I would like to know, my name is Camille Frazier, and I would like to know, Gladys, how old are you?
27.
Okay, Gladys, you came through that very fine, all four of you, as a matter of fact, and I'd like to ask you what you're going to do for us next.
We'd like to do for you our latest soul recording. We just received a gold record for it. I don't want to do wrong.
Beautiful. Let's make some more noise for Gladys Knight. Hi, we're back with two more members of our Soul Train gang. And you know, in as much as dancing styles vary so much in different parts of the country, we'd like to feature dance couples from time to time who live in the various cities we serve. It gives you a chance to compare their style with the style of dancing in your area. Now, this couple is from Chicago, Illinois, and you are?
Danae Williams.
Hi, Danae.
Vaughn Fonda.
But no, Vaughn. Danae, tell us, what are the most popular dances in Chicago now?
Sex Machine, The Breakdown, The Popeye.
Mm-hmm. And Vaughn, which are you and Danae going to do?
We'll try The Breakdown.
Okay, supplying the music, the Memphis Bulldog himself, Mr. Rufus Thomas, and the thing he calls Do That Breakdown, Chili. Thomas with The Breakdown, and we thank Danae and Vaughn for that fine demonstration. As you saw, it's a fun dance to do. Right now, let's get some hands together once again for three extraordinary canaries. They are the fantastic Honeycomb.
Heartbreak in the first degree.
is absolutely fabulous. I know who you are. You're Edna Wright, right?
Edna Wright?
From where?
From Los Angeles.
From Los Angeles.
And I'm Carolyn Willis from Los Angeles.
Hey, Carolyn.
Shelley Clark, Ellie also.
What Mary, Shelley? Edna, I'm going to ask you about the beautiful name, the Honeycomb. Where did it come from?
Oh, well, it came from one of the guys that discovered us. Mm-hmm. And frankly, the idea stung us.
Okay, let's give it up one more time for the Honeycomb. And it's dance contest time. We'll judge the Soul Train Gang in what we call a freestyle, which means they can do any dance they feel they do best. We judge our couples on the basis of enthusiasm and how well they dance together as a team. You may recognize some of the dances depending on the area of the country you live in, but the most important thing to note is that the winning couple will be eligible to compete next spring along with all subsequent winners for $10,000 in college scholarships to be awarded by the Johnson Products Company. So you can believe the kids are not going to be stuffing, baby. They're going to be sure nothing. So supplying the contest music, a groove that sure enough makes you want to move real smooth, out of Chicago, Illinois, Semtex Simmons, Wally Dixon, gotta get over the hump. Okay, there you have it, a super tough contest to judge with everybody on the floor really getting down. We'll be back in just a moment with the winning couple after a message from the good folks at Sears. How about a round of applause for our wedding couple? Congratulations, and what's your name?
Renee Armelin.
Hi, Renee.
Tony Crandall.
Hey, Tony. Now, Renee, what's the name of the dance you were doing?
The Cracker Jack.
Okay, we've got Semtex and Wally getting over the hump again. Show us how you did it with that Cracker Jack.
I'm so tired of other guys beating me to the draw.
Congratulations again. I know you're both interested in college. Renee, what would you like to major in when you finally get there?
Psychology.
And
pre-med.
Beautiful. Well, as I mentioned earlier, Soul Train Dance Contest finals will be held on the show in the spring for all winners, including this couple, competing for $10,000 in scholarships from the Johnson Products Company. Right now, I'm going to ask the audience at home and the Soul Train gang up in here to really give it up for a mighty soul brother by the name of Eddie Kendricks.
Ooh.
And that brings us to the end of what we hope has been a beautiful trip for you and what certainly has been a groovy ride for me. We thank you for joining us. We thank our very exciting guests, Gladys Knight and the Pips, the Honeycone, Bobby Hutton, special guest Eddie Kendricks, and of course, the Soul Train Gang. Hope you'll climb aboard next week on these same stations, and you can bet your last money it's all going to be a stone gas, honey. Always in parting, we're going to wish you love, peace, and soul. Thank you.